The families couldn't agree. They were yelling and screaming at each other. I was watching them. And when they finished, I told them, this will happen. He will do what I said. So finally, I put them all out. Within 1 hour, I texted them, he has done it. They have been trying for months to get him to do it. I got it done in less than 1 hour. I made the decree in Atlanta before I boarded the flight. By your words, you shall be justified. By your words. The people surrounding Jericho were told not to say something. This time, you are told, while you are walking, start declaring, on the seventh time, your wall is coming down. On the seventh time, you are coming down. As I'm marching, the glory of God is digging a hole for the wall to fall in. I march around in faith. I march around with power. I march around in authority. It's my fight and it's my win. Amen. 8 months. I kept talking to that place. He hasn't recovered yet. I overcame it in 2003. Isn't that 2003? He hasn't recovered. He's been shut down since 2003. This is 2000. How many years is that? 21 years. My words are still holding. You can't wiggle out of this. I have you roped from head to toe. Wiggle all you want to. You are bound by my words. And on the seventh time, on the seventh day, God said, march around it seven times. Don't you see? You cannot be feeble. You must take care of God's temple. Amen. So you'll be strong. Amen. Huh? Amen. You guys should be getting yourself ready for glory for USA. Amen. So when we exit, you carry on. We don't want to exit and you're all filled with sick folks and weak folks, and y'all are, hey, don't let me come back from the dead and start chasing some of you. Huh? You have faith to do what I'm doing. You have to pay the bills of a jet. You have to pay the price of marching around them capitals. God said, I've given you the seventh day, seven times anointed and grace. Israel had to march around once a day. On the seventh day, they do it seven times and shout. Amen. And I bypassed the first six. Amen. And gave you the seven-day breakthrough. Amen. How can you be sitting under a seven-day breakthrough ministry? Huh? And you're tolerating your stuff not working. You prophesy every day. You declare it every day. I'm not taking no for an answer. You gotta put your faith in motion. Stop waiting for something to happen. Give God the weapon to use. Look at what the grace of God has produced. Elder Bob is 78. Elder Thomas is what? 78, too. October. Oh. I didn't know you belonged to October. So from now on, I will grant you a special favor since you're born in the right month. Yeah. 78. and marching and shouting. And some of you are 35 and aching all over. My brother got angry with me. He said, Chiki, we are retired. Because they retire in England at 55. I said, come to Resurrection House. You see somebody in her 80s taking pictures and running around. He said, what are you trying to say? Nothing, just come. You get the message yourself. I said, the people doing Glory for USA are in their late 70s. They're older than you. Glory for USA is hard on the body. I know Pastor Benito watches the messages every week, so he'll hear himself, hear about himself. We were playing ping pong, and I was telling him how tedious Glory for USA is. He said, oh, come on, it's nothing. That he walks 5 miles a day, that he will be a piece of cake, and this and that and the other. I almost get angry. I said, but why will I be getting angry? No, I need to take him to Glory for. All right. So I invited him to Glory for USA. So he hopped in, flying in a private jet. He said, Pops, this is great. He didn't know what I was thinking. You think Glory for USA is flying in the jet? So we landed, we did the first state. Then we left and did the second state. And then we left and did the third state. And then the next morning, get up for family altar or for, you know, morning devotion. He said he woke up and he was looking for his foot. I said, oh, really? He said, I couldn't feel my feet. I said, no, it's piece of day. I walk 5 miles a day. He said, this stuff is no joke. I'm not going to lie. I said, oh, you are converted, eh? It is hard on the body. It's not just the walk. It's the spiritual warfare behind the walk. Don't you see what's happening across America? You know the altars are speaking. I remember in Oklahoma when I stood before that statue. You all remember that, you guys? You were there. All of you were here. And I made the decree. I even made the decree about the education system that teacher salary will be raised across America. And I called down that principality that they instituted in that statue. I even made a decree. I said, watch, Oral Roberts, T.L. Osborne.
Oral Roberts.
Amen.
T.L. Osborne.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You shall not go down, but you shall rise.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Jesus Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
We bring the altar of God to
Hallelujah.
You, Oklahoma.
Amen.
Lord, hear the word of the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The altar of God has been raised.
Amen. Amen.
The angels of God are descending.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
To carry out this mandate.
Amen.
In the name of the Father.
Amen. Amen.
Son Jesus.
Amen.
And the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
We give thanks.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
And the altar of God is rising here.
Amen.
To speak for the next 12 months.
Amen.
May the angel of God man this altar, O Lord.
Hallelujah.
By covenant.
Hallelujah. Amen.
To carry out his decree.
Amen.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Decree a glory takeover in the educational system.
Amen.
Anybody walking through here must submit
Amen.
To the authority and the power
Amen.
Of the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We will expect full recovery
yes, Amen.
For Oklahoma.
Yes, Amen. Lord.
The greatness that produced the sons that shook the world
Amen.
Shall produce one again.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
All these people came out of Oklahoma. But they left and their children don't have the same clout, the same power, the same. I make decrees against the demonic forces that accomplish that. That they must be snatched down. And now, Oklahoma is about to put 10 commandments in all the schools. In every classroom. In every courtroom. Hey! The altars are speaking! That's why the march is so tough on the body. Because you are going against devils that have been there for years. Watch. And when they did the seventh march, God said, shout, for the Lord has given you. Watch. He said, shout, for the Lord has given you the victory.
Amen. Amen.
But watch. Remember at the beginning, he said to Joshua, see, I have given you Jericho, the king, and all the people. Huh? Are you ready for my bullets? You shout to release what God showed you. You think I just said that? Let me show it to you. It is. Look at Psalm 47. You release the shout. When Israel shouted, he said the wall fell. You heard the, what are those guys that making all the music from Carolina? Huh? Elevation. The young man said that when the wall came, fell, it formed a bridge for them to go into the city. Watch. Look at Psalm 47. If you're in doubt of what I'm telling you. Oh, clap your hands. All ye people, shout unto God. You notice, when I tell you to shout, sometimes I tell you that shout won't right. He says, the voice of triumph. Amen. Triumph has a voice. Amen. Hallelujah. The same way murmuring and complaining has a voice. Depression has a voice. Triumph! Somebody giving a death blow to Satan should have a shout that reaches a threshold. It's a voice of triumph. In other words, when heaven looks at you and listens to you, you are shouting like a man that knows they have the victory. Okay? He said you shouted, but you didn't get it. Watch. I say you shout like a man that knows that they have the victory.
Yeah.
What? Not a man believing that their shout will produce the victory.
Amen.
See the difference?
Yeah.
You say you should shout unto God. Yeah. Look at what happens in a shout. For the Lord Most High, we shout to release the terribleness of God. When you said the Lord is terrible, hallelujah, he's a consuming fire. His might, his power, his majesty. And this thing has been so hard for us to do alone. We shout in the sanctuary, but we haven't been able to do it privately, alone at home, when nobody's telling you to shout. It's time for you to make a fool out of yourself. Huh? Act crazy. Shout marching around. Shout walking around the house. Shout. May the Lord be terrible to my enemies. Watch. Look at what else. For he's a great king over all the earth. I release his majesty. He's contained in the shout. How terrible are you, Lord? I release your majesty. Watch this. He shall subdue. He brings all rebels down. That's why I don't engage in strife. If God sent me, he would deal with you, the rebel. I don't have to get into strife with you. I'll give you your space. Carry on. You run into it. David learned it. He said, it's God that will subdue the people. We don't make them. It's God that makes them. He said, the servant of the Lord must not strive. There's no place for strife in this kingdom. None. Watch. And the nations under our feet. Resurrection House for all nations. The nations under our feet. Stadium Crusades. The nations under our feet. The nations under our feet. He shall choose our inheritance for us. Hallelujah. The excellency of Jacob. Hey. When God makes choices for you, he makes excellent choices. When you make choices for you, you make terrible choices. The excellency of Jacob, whom he loved. Selah. Hallelujah. Isn't that what they're saying? Shout in triumph. Huh? Jesus is alive. He said, shout. They shouted. And the walls of Jericho fell and they marched straight in. I need to throw this in so I won't come back here. Watch. And God said to them, as you're going into the city, everything is accursed. You have to learn the power of the first fruit. See, everything is accursed. Gather everything. I am the only one that can handle it.
Amen. Yeah.
That's what I do. When somebody gives me money and they're not willing to go through the glory test to make sure it's accurate, I always turn it into God. I can't handle what God hasn't anointed. Mm-mm. If there's a question, I turn it in. He said, gather up all the accursed things and bring it into the treasury of my house. And then after Jericho, everything else you get, you can keep. But you must give me first.
Amen.
To release the curse from every other conquest. Amen. Don't you see ignorant children talking against tithing? You don't have a chance.
Amen.
Huh? You don't know the dollar bill you just received. Who had it? But because you have covenant with God, when you touch that money, the curse drops. Hallelujah. The witches, they're making incantations. The gays, they're making incantations. They're diabolical. You protect yourself by the covenant of God. God said, bring everything into the storehouse. And then after this, whoever else you conquer, you can keep anything. So long as you've given me first. I don't know why anybody can be preaching anything else. What kingdom are you in? What breakthrough do you have? And they went in. He said, destroy everything. Except the harlot and her family. And they told the harlot, the thread you used to lower us across the wall, hang it on your window. When we see that, hallelujah, then we know who it is. And we will not touch you. Come on, Resurrection House. I can give you one shot before I leave. If a harlot can change kingdoms and deliver her entire family. Don't shout yet. You mean the family that have been running her down all these years, talking about how terrible she was living and how she was embarrassing the family and all those negative things. But the day she changed kingdoms, she became the avenue. for their deliverance. If a harlot can change their family, yes, you can. Yes, you can. You will not shout. I say, yes, you can. I can imagine the conversation. And the parents were, where did you meet this man? I wish you'd been meeting this kind of man all these years. I told you that the very thing Satan uses against you and rubs your nose in it, that's the same thing God will use to defeat him. It was men that messed her up, but it was men that saved her and her family. Give God credit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, stand to your feet. Glory to God. Huh? Every generational curse must fall because of you. What did the harlot do? She didn't go repenting of her sins. I'm praying about it a million years. She just lined up with God. Amen. So whatever God you're doing, I want in on it. She told the spies, we know that God has given you the land. But the others did not act on their faith. She did. She hid the spies and lied to the king. Only a harlot can do that. No man of integrity can do that. So God used her weakness to get the job done. Beloved, these messages are treasure troves of miracles, insights, revelations. You learn how God works in the practicum. You see the grace of God defeat the taunts of Satan in years. Huh? Can you imagine the harlot Rahab ending up in the genealogy of Jesus? That is God's affront to Satan. Can you imagine what an embarrassment she was to her family and to the culture? How she was talked about, vilified, and yet some of the people talking against her were the ones visiting her. And she makes a change. She embraced the spies. She believed in the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And she was the instrument God used to save her entire family. Who have you written off? Repent. Who have you given up on? Repent. The grace of God is stronger than the devil. For we're saying about grace doth much more about. It doesn't feel like that when you're struggling. It doesn't feel like that when you're in the fight. That's the power of faith. You use faith to get over the storm, to get over that hump, to believe for breakthroughs unseen, and God will honor your faith. And if a harlot can save an entire family, yes, you can. Learn the ways of resurrection. Yes, you can. Every member of this church has been mandated by God to go back and destroy generational curses in their family and free their relatives. You are the end of that satanic tirade and almost unfettered success. We're closing the door on him by learning the covenants that are higher than his. Amen. You notice God did not remove gravity, otherwise we can't function. But he taught us lift to get over gravity. And now we can fly airplanes and launch rockets and all these things. Yes, he's not going to change life. He's not going to stop lust and all this stuff. No, these things will remain. But he gives grace for us to get over them and overcome them. Call today 770-994-3777 if lust has taking your mind over, trying to destroy your life and ministry. Call 770-994-3777. Don't be embarrassed. expose Satan, and God will do a miracle. Receive in Jesus' name. Put a seed in the ground for your deliverance. Sow today. Money answer it all things. Sow today is the variable seed. Sow today is the power of the kingdom released. Sow today is a covenant agreement that produces miracles. Amen. We thank God for it. It's such a testimony that should rejoice your heart and give you hope in your struggle. You're not going to end up there, lady. You're not going to end up there. I said that because I saw a flash of an African-American woman. You have a short hair, and I think is a red or orange blouse. Dark skin. That testimony is not going to end there. Your testimony is not going to end there. The grace of God. That's what brought you to watch The Voice of Resurrection today, or maybe see it on YouTube. I don't know where you're watching it from, but I'm describing you, and God is sending you a word of hope. Get up and lift your hands. Begin to worship the Lord and thank Him that He's visited you today. That's the way it was. After 17 years of battling this illness, suddenly I was healed and I didn't even know when it happened. That's the way God is. If you keep going and trust Him, one day He'll say, okay, that's enough. You'll come out of it in Jesus' name. Amen. Don't forget Bible study, 7 p.m. every Wednesday night. We keep you only 2 hours, 7 to 9. God will bless your life. September the 15th is All Nations Sunday. God has given us tools to reach the nations, and we are progressing gradually into that destiny. Ministry evolves. It's not one day. You just grow in grace, from glory to glory, from grace to grace, from revelation to understanding, and then mighty breakthroughs. The theme this year is Jesus, Holy Ghost, and Revival. Habakkuk 2:14. The glory of the Lord shall cover the earth as the waters cover the sea. Come and see fantastic opening scenes and the theatrical lightings and the smoke and the glory and all of that. Ooh, it's fantastic. Worship with us that day. God will touch your life and bless you. We love you. Gotta go. See you tomorrow in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Bye-bye. My dead face comes.